You know, the NLP really looked at what was happening, but not only what was happening, how did it operate? So now we get to the place where it's called strategies in NLP. And they recognized that, you know, how something was happening wasn't conscious. The brain is a pattern-making machine. What it does is it's a learning machine. You're learning machines. So what happens is when you look out into the world with your five senses, and what happens is it keeps patterning in, okay? So we often say the brain loves what's the same, but learns by what's different, okay? So it looks for new stuff, brings it back in, and habituates, naturalizes, and basically now you don't know that you know. That's why you don't know when you're opening a door, how to open the door, you just do it, yeah? Basically because you've learned it already. Now, that's where strategies come in. There are parts of your behavior that you've learned how to do, and you don't know how you know. But there was a time when you were just learning. You weren't aware of how to do it. There was a time where it was just like driving, you didn't know how to do it. There's something that you're brilliant at, basically, something that you're really good at, and you don't even have to think about it, okay? We often call it your superpower, okay? So what we call, basically, it's, you know, it's effortless excellence with humble authority. You know, you begin to recognize when you feel that you're doing something that's not work. It's just, this is what I do, this is who I am. It's kind of your raison d'etre, or the reason for being, or this is what you're made to do. Now, can you imagine if you could model those parts? Can you imagine if you could actually, and modeling is really mapping it out. Strategies are an element of modeling whereby you're mapping out the thinking process of that individual. How exactly are they doing it? Now remember, they cannot tell you how they're doing it because it's unconscious. How is a person doing something? In order for you to figure that out, you have to make the unconscious more conscious, okay? So we need to be able to find out what the client doesn't know or what the subject doesn't know about what they know, right? And we're saying earlier on, unconscious competence. So if I had to find out what it is that you're doing well, I have to go past what you remember consciously because you're already doing it automatically, which means it's unconscious. So I have to find out, okay, by asking questions, I'm gonna find out the stuff that you have forgotten. And then you bring it back into the surface. Doing a whole lot of other things, which you've forgotten them because they're now a pattern. Okay, they're a habit. So they're unconscious. That's how the brain is always making things. It's a pattern making machine. So it's always pulling things into the unconscious to automate it so that you're free for other stuff. So your idea here is to begin to map across the strategy to find out where does it begin? Where does threshold happen? Remember we're talking about emotions. Emotions have thresholds. So a threshold, when a threshold happens, it means I'm moving. There's a transition happening. So you need to look at what's the logical sequence of what I'm saying. Where does the actual strategy begin, okay? How do I stay on track? How do I know when I'm off track? And these are all about some modalities. So is it a picture changes? Is it like, does it become closer or near? Is it something I imagined or something that I remembered? What is it? Yeah, basically, so what happened for that to happen? And what was the internal check I'm doing all the time? And you see people doing internal checks all the time, okay?